Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Net Tracker. Today I will be telling you about the SET exam of Himachal. So people who are new to my channel, I would just like to tell that this is an educational channel where you will be getting information regarding the National Eligibility Test and State Eligibility Test exams. So I will be keep updating you regarding all these exams which are being conducted in various states as per the time, and you will also get quite good enough of study material from this channel. So all the people who are interested can please subscribe to my channel. And today I will be discussing about the main concept about the Himachal Pradesh State Eligibility Test. So people who have given NET exam before, they might be quite familiar with this thing, but people who are new, to them I would just like to tell that state eligibility tests are conducted so that the universities and colleges can recruit their assistant professors with the help of these exams, because this is the minimum criteria, SET or NET. These two exams one need to crack if they want to teach at any government college or any university. So this exam is conducted every year. So without any further ado, I would tell you that if you are interested in filling up this form, you need to visit Himachal Pradesh Public Service Commission website, and there you will see this advertisement regarding State Eligibility Test 2017. So the last date to fill this form is 27 November 2017. So only a few days are left, so people who are interested, they need to fill up this form as soon as possible, right? And this exam will be conducted in February or March in 2018, right? So people calculate from here that how much time is left, and they need to prepare themselves accordingly. And these cities in which these exams will be conducted are like Shimla, Solan, Mandi, Sundarnagar, Dharamchala, Palampur and Kangra. So you can choose your center from all these locations. And here is the list of all the subjects which will be covered in this exam. So if you have studied any of these papers in your master's degree, you can apply for this exam in those subjects only. Right, so you can see the list. Here are 22 subjects given. So choose accordingly the subject which you have taken in your master's. So for the eligibility of this exam, I will tell you that it is mandatory for a person to have a master's degree, and that too with a minimum of 55% of marks if you are belonging to a general category. If you are from SCST or any other backward classes, or you have a person with a disability, for all those people it is 50% mandatory to be their score in their master's degree, right? And there is some more information regarding this. You can download this and read this advertisement before filling up the form. And here is the schema for the exam. So here you can see that there are three papers in which it will be conducted. It will be in two phases. In the first phase, you will have paper 1 and paper 2. And after lunch, in the second phase, you will have your third paper. So here you can see that 50 questions will be asked in paper 1 in 75 minutes. And similarly, for the paper 2, you have 50 questions and 75 minutes will be given for that paper. So these two papers are like quite scoring. So over here, you can see that in paper 3, you have 75 questions and time is 150 minutes. As this paper is quite lengthy, like for people who have numerical based questions, for them 150 minutes are like good amount of time to solve the questions, right? So in paper 1, you can see that teaching, research aptitude, reasoning ability, comprehension and divergent thinking and general awareness, these are the topics which will be covered in your paper 1, right? So you can score well in these in this paper. And in paper 2 and paper 3, the questions will be asked from your subject which you have chosen for this exam. So in paper 3, I think a more detailed question will be asked. So you need to study your syllabus thoroughly. And the criteria for declaration of result is that the aggregate of all these three papers will be calculated, and all the people who have will score like top 6% of the marks in the exam, they will be declared as qualified. So to get yourself into top 6%, you actually need to study really hard. So this is the criteria for the selection. And after that, here is the link for the syllabus from where you can download your syllabus for the subjects, right? And here is the mode of payment and the examination fee. For general category, it is 700 rupees. For backward classes, it is 350. For SCST of Himachal Pradesh, it is 175. And for PWD, it is again 175. So you can fill your application form and pay the examination fee in two modes. Here, first is the easiest way is to buy to e-banking, right? Or the second option is by taking e-challans. So after you have applied for this exam, an e-challan will be generated on your ID. So from there, you need to download it and deposit it in the Punjab National Bank. And after that, you will come back and log into your account, and you will update the e-challan information over there. Only after that, your So here again, the link is given from where you can apply, and here are the general information, right? So you can read them before going into the exam. They are basic information, like you need to bring in photo identity proof and like no cell phones and pagers or any electronic device can be used. No TA will be given, and admit card is compulsory to be brought on that day. All these information you can study. So with this, I think I have covered all the things, important things. So the thing what I want to say is that you first download this advertisement, go through it thoroughly, and after that only fill the examination form. Next videos, I will be taking up a few important topics regarding computer science, as it is my subject. So we will be studying it in detail so that we can practice for this exam. And along with that, I will be solving few previous year's question paper. So be tuned, and all those people who are like really interested in giving this exams, for them, I will also be putting up some study material on this channel. So please do subscribe to my channel and stay tuned. And we will meet in the next lecture. So thank you for watching.